at the outset, I thank the Honorable HRD Minister for bringing this bill, and this is a progressive step in a right direction. This is the second in the series of the bill that government is bringing in to satisfy the requirements of what have been stated in AP Reorganization Act 13th schedule. We wholeheartedly support this bill. However, I have 7 issues which I would like to bring to the notice of the Honorable HRD Minister, and I am very confident that he will address all the issues, because each of the issues is very important on its own. Sir, particularly the establishment which IIT which has been established in Tirupati last year August has been started in temporary private premises, and state government has allotted 509 acres of land, and last year there was a budgetary allocation of 40 crores, and this year there is an allocation of 20 crores, and according to the DPR, the total requirement of funds that are to be invested to make it as a full-fledged institution, it is 1,750 crores. I am very confident, because yesterday Honorable HRD Minister has promised that there will be significant budgetary allocations that would be made in the years to come, and he assured the House that all these institutions which he is contemplating to establish now by virtue of this amendment bill would be made standards of national standards in the next 2-3 years to come. Sir, secondly, see, in Tirupati it is only undergraduate course which the government of India has started in IIT, and only 4 branches, 4 streams, that is civil, mechanical and electrical, and also computer sciences. All these 4 courses have been started last year, and I urge the minister, Honorable HRD Minister, to increase the number of courses and number of branches, and increase the number of students also, student strength from 30 to at least 50, because this is the second academic year of the starting of the institution. Sir, thirdly, I urge the Honorable HRD Minister to start the post-graduation course also in Tirupati, and even in other places which now the bill seeks to establish. And also the research program. Then only we can say that these institutes would be of national importance and satisfy the requirements of IIT standards. Sir, very recently, my next point, that fourth point is, very recently, about 4 months back, an advertisement has been given by IIT Tirupati for the post of professors, associate professors and assistant professors. It is surprising to us that this advertisement, according to this advertisement, these posts are required to be filled up on either on contract basis or on deputation basis. We really don't understand posts of this top level posts are to be filled on contract basis or deputation basis. I hope Honorable Minister will address that issue. Sir, for Tirupati, IIT Tirupati, which has been established last year, has no director. No full-fledged director. The director, 2 more points, sir. The director, Chennai, is a mentor director for Tirupati as well as for the institute which is constituted at Palakkad. So one director look after 3 institutes, IIT institutes? This is my question. So I urge the Honorable HRD Minister to appoint independent directors for each of the institutes which he is proposing to establish now. Sir, next point, 6th point is...
Please conclude.
Sir, I'm concluding. One more point. As our senior honorable member, C.P. Narayanan, has stated yesterday, that educationally and socially backward students are finding it difficult to cope up with the standards. Therefore, the Kerala government has established coaching centers, according to him, to make the students on par with the other students, and they'll be able to compete with the other students also. I hope the central government in this bill would establish such institutes, coaching institutes, so that these socially and educationally backward students also would compete with the other students and the standards would be maintained. Sir, one last point, only one point, sir. See, the dropouts, according to the statistics, for the last 3 years is about 2,000 in all IITs put together. And particularly last year, 757 is the dropout. I hope by establishing these coaching centers, I am very confident the figure of dropout would come down in future. Sir, last point, sir. The government of India has announced a scheme by name Uchchatar Avishkar Yojana, whereby...
Please conclude. Time is over.
It's over, sir. Whereby the help of IITs was taken under the scheme to make an India scheme successful. I really don't understand why IIT Tirupati's help is not sought in this regard. Therefore, I urge upon the Honorable HRD Minister to clarify all the issues which I have brought it to his notice.
Ek naya nara chala hai. Gaon mein, shahron mein, kabzon mein ek naya nara chala hai. Kasbon mein bachche keh rahe hain, Arhar Modi, Arhar Modi, Arhar Modi, Arhar Modi.